In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Let's be aware of the grace and the goodness of God. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Great joy in that city. Now, when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that went down and prayed for them. They might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not yet fallen on any of them, and they had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. love me, you will keep my commandments. I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always, the Spirit of truth that the world cannot accept, because it neither sees nor knows him. But you know him, because he remains with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me because I live, and you will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in the Father, and you are in me, and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. Whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him. The Gospel of the Lord. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope. I guess the first question we have to ask is, do we even have hope? Do we have a hope-filled day? Not just one, every day. Is our heart filled with a sense, as the Gospel says, of Christ, with the triune God who spirates within us, who gives us meaning and purpose? That should be our hope. Now, the reason we go about doing the good works and the good deeds that we do is not for any other purpose than God has certainly blessed me in his love. And I know that in the core of my being, in the core of my soul, and therefore, since I know it, I offer it to others. Because what we recognize when that happens is, I didn't make it happen. I simply opened my heart, and God was there. And God began to fill it with joy, with peace, with consolation. And that which he fills me with, I find more joy by giving hope to others. Do we have that? Are we going around giving an explanation? It's not only an explanation, because an explanation can be very important. Well, I have hope. No, it should be exemplified in what we do. People should see it and say, that person has hope. That person has love, goodness, generosity. That's who God is. That's who's supposed to be filling our hearts. As we do that, that's what God is saying. Because the advocate comes to fill us up, to help us to know who Christ is, and once we know Christ, we know the love of the Father, and that fills the mind, the heart, and the spirit, and it transforms us within. Just something to think about, let's say. Christ comes, and that is, in the sense of Acts of the Apostles, heals the mind, the body, and the soul, transforms it into the goodness and richness of life, and when that happens, we want to share. So I guess the question we need to ask ourselves is, why have hope? If I don't, maybe I better ask, Spirit, please fill my heart. Help me know the Son, so that I can know the Father, and know how you're spirating in my life, the very breath and depth of your life within me, so that I do have hope. Do we have hope? If not, maybe that's something to ask the Spirit for this week. Something to think about this week. Together, let us confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From then he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And now we bring our needs to our gracious God. for the church, forming the spirit as the body of Christ. May God graciously grant us all we need as we proclaim the good news, we pray to the Lord. For world leaders and the good news of the gospel guided actions, we pray to the Lord. For those who are sick, especially those who feel alone in their struggle, may they experience the comfort of our loving God, we pray to the Lord. For those who have died, may they find peace and eternal joy in the Lord, we pray to the Lord. For Mary Jane Edwards, and for the intentions that we have in our hearts that we add in silence. We pray to the Lord. Gracious God, in our prayers and answer them through Christ our Lord.
As they acclaim.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took a chalice and once more giving thanksgiving to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which we poured out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of
thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty and living God, restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ. Increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord. Remember, please leave your pew down. That tells us where you have sat and what places you need to clean. And I need a few people to use some of our Clorox spray bottles to help clean. There are some rags in the plastic bags, and then you'll see on the floor a bucket that you put those rags into after using them. And thank you for all of you helping with cleaning the church. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ to love and serve the Lord.